anachronistic. I heard four. It's down here somewhere, right? What are the coordinates right there? Read it to me. Good. All right, so is sine the x value or the y value? A y, good. It's negative square root of 3 over 2. Okay? Make sure you're getting good with the area in the circle, one way or the other, the triangles or coordinates, because eventually there's going to be a caboose come up. And I would have to do something quickly. That was one of it, right? All right, so make sure you're practicing with it. All right, looking at this one. Really, there probably should have been some parentheses there. Is negative 5 pi over 4 on our unit circle? No. Okay, so what am I going to do? Add 2 pi to get it positive. So in over 4 world, what is 2 pi? Good. So we're looking for the cosine of what, really? 3 pi over 4. All right, what quadrant is 2 pi over 4 in? Second quadrant is that one right there, right? And what are the coordinates there? Good. All right, and so the cosine is which of those values? The first one, negative square root of 2. Good. Okay. Just have to do one up here. All right. Go ahead and fill those in. Functions, but they're identities. If you look on either side of the room, look at the green sign. It's like the second one from the end. Okay, see the green sign? It's the same thing as what's right there. Okay? So an even function is something, and this is definition of every even function, not just for trig. Okay? If I plug a negative value into it, when you put it in, it becomes positive. And that's just the rule with these. We plug that even in on the cosecant line and secant, which happen to be the reciprocals of each other, it goes to positive. Okay? On the other ones, we know it's odd if when you plug in a negative, it becomes a negative of the original. Okay? So on the all the other four are odd. Okay? Typically we think even like this, right? They point the same way because it has an exponent of x squared, right? And odd is like something cubic, right? They point opposite ways. That's not so for trig, okay? So we have to have this other method. So that's where we plug in the negative x. Or whatever. They use t. The sign up here uses u's. Okay? All right, so let's check and see if we've got, let's see, we're talking, use the trig value, the trig function to evaluate the independent functions. Okay, so we're supposed to put in, we know that the sine of t equals negative 1/5. So when we have sine of a negative t, does the negative go away or does it move out front? That's basically what happened here. Either it went away or it moved out front, right? So it's got to move out front, so I'm going to move it out front. And again, if you forget, you're going to look at the green sign, right? The green sign tells you. All right, so it moves out front. And so it's really negative sine t. Okay. All right. And then, so all I have to do is plug in what sine t reciprocal. Okay? So I'm going to keep the negative, and I'm going to do the reciprocal of sine, which is going to be 5 over 1, or simply negative 5. Same type of problem, right? This time I'm using cosine and secant. Alright, so first we're going to go to our identity there. For the cosine, where there's a negative on the inside, does it disappear or does it move out front? It disappears, so I'm really just looking at the cosine of t. Alright, for secant, when I have a negative on the inside, does it disappear or go out front? Here, so secant of t. Now, if I have cosine, how do I get secant? You flip it, it's the reciprocal, right? So we've got 3 over 5. I'm not doing a whole lot of things, right? Alright. Now, the last few are all on the calculator. Alright? So, we need to make sure we're in the right mode. Okay, so we're going to do some mode switching today. Is this angle measure that they gave me there, is that in degrees or in radians? That's radians. How do you know? There's a pi. That's your big clue. Okay? There is not a degree symbol. If there is a degree symbol, you are in degrees. On the next test, you're going to have to go between the two on the test. Okay? All right, so let's go ahead and double check our mode first. Okay, so you're going to hit the home button. You're not already there. You're going to go to settings. And we're going to go to doc settings, and you want to make sure that the angle says radian. And remember, when you're using your calculators, when you're going to put trig in your calculator, you have to make sure it's in the right mode. Remember, calculus always puts it back in radian on you. Okay? They only work in radian. You guys work between the two. Okay? All right, and then click make default, click OK. Go ahead to your scratch pad to calculate. You need to find the pi. So trig, if sine is under the trig button, I'd probably hit it this one by the fraction of me. And then 2 pi. You know what pi is? Next to the h, right? And it's better to use the pi than the 3.14. I never 3.14, always do pi, because a calculator takes it out as many decimal places. Down 0.866, right? Okay. Not that hard, right? That wasn't example 12?
That was 14.
That was 12. Oh, interesting. That's 0.14. Okay. 0.8. Yeah, that's weird. Alright, so this was apparently 14. Okay. This is your 12. Nice. Okay. Is there a degree symbol on that cotangent of 1.5? No. If there's no degree symbol, you assume radians. Okay, so go ahead and put that one in. Our calculator's already in the right mode. Okay? We'll let you try it. We'll shout out the NCL, let's give everybody a chance. Everybody in a minute. Technically, if you wanted to, you could put the word radians after it.